Guys, welcome to yet another episode which I'm going to make on practicals, and today I'm going to make a video on three commands which are being executed on a cloud. So what we are going to do is we are going to upload a file on a cloud, and we are going to download that file again, and we are going to see which files are there on the cloud. Okay, so for that you need to make an account on this website which is called CloudMe. Okay, so let us go there. So you have to make an account on this, and I have already made an account, so let us sign in. So it's not a difficult task to log in, okay, and you can sign up very easily. They give around 10 GB of free space, and then afterwards they will charge you. So here is the cloud, and you can store everything. You can see whatever files you have in the home directory, sort of directory. And I have made this folder AK, okay, and we have down documents as well. So you can upload files, you can download files, you can delete files from this cloud. Alright, so now let us look at the code. Okay, so this is the small code which I have written, and to code it in Java we need some jar files. Okay, for the link for those files is given in the description box, and you can attach those files in your project. So to attach those files, go to your project, right click on it and go to properties, okay, and then go to libraries, and then here you can see the jar files. To add these jar files, you can go here and click add jar. Okay, so here are those files. Okay, so these jar files are required for making the connection. Okay, for these are sort of a driver. Okay, so now let us look at the code. So first of all, what we are going to do, we are going to log in into the cloud. So for that you need to create an object of CloudMe user, okay, and you have to give the username and password with that. You can use my password, and you can create folders, okay, and then you need to ask the user whether he want to upload a file or he want to download a file, or just you want to view the folders and files on the cloud. Okay, so it is just a simple statement, and then you can take input from the user, and then you can declare a switch case, and you can give three conditions in it. So first condition is what? Upload a file. Okay, so to upload a file you need to give the path of the folder, okay, or you need to create a new folder. So what I'm doing, I'm asking the user whether you want to create a new folder or you want to use existing folder. Okay, so if the user types yes, then I'm comparing that with yes. Okay, so on this line, and then I'm asking for the name of the folder, okay, which you want to create. Then declaring this CloudMe folder object, and then I'm creating a new folder using get folder manager instance. So this function will manage all the folders on the cloud. Okay, so it will create a new folder, and whichever name you give to that folder, okay, along with the address where you have to create that. Okay, then if you want to use already existing folder, so don't give input as yes. Okay, you can give any other input. Then it will ask for the location of that folder. Okay, here is that line. So it will ask for the location, and then you have to get that instance from get folder manager method. Okay, so it will give you that object. Okay, now it will display it has got the folder. If there is something wrong, it will go into the exception. Okay, then it will ask for the file name along with its path and its extension as well. If you want to upload a PDF file, so you have to give its its absolute or total path, okay? Then along with that path, in the end you have to give the name of the file and extension of that file, okay, like PDF or JPG, etc. So then you need to execute this command, okay? So you call this method folder.upload file, and then the total total path of that file on your PC, okay? And then it will display this message, file uploaded successfully, okay? Now let us see the second case where you want to download a file. So what you have to give as input is the location of the file on the cloud, in which directory it is. So then it will create an object of CloudMe file, and it will get that file. After that it will read that file, and then it will ask where you want to store that file on your PC, okay? Then you have to give the path where you have to store that, along with the name of the file and its extension, okay? And then it will download that file, okay? So this is a simple code, and in the end you want to check each and every file on the cloud. So what you need to do, you need to get the folder tree, okay? The entire tree you need to get from the cloud. So it will create an object of CloudMe folder node. So so it will get the entire tree of the folders, okay? So it has a root folder, then its child folders, okay? And then we are writing a for loop, and we are going through each and every children or a child of the folders, okay? And then in each folder we are checking for the files. So CloudMe file is an object, okay? So it will iterate through every files in a specific folder. So it will go through each and every folder and files, okay? And it will display that file. So this is, so in the end we need to kill the user, okay? Not literally, but we need to kill that object. So this is how it is, and now let us run this. It will take some time. Okay. So first of all, we will upload a file. Okay. So it is asking whether you want to create a new folder. So let us create a new folder. Okay. So the name of the folder is, let us say what? EISSMS. Okay. Okay. Okay, so now it is asking for the file which we need to upload. So let us see what we have. Let us upload our syllabus, okay? So the syllabus is in fdrive/b. Let us copy this thing. It is a PDF file, okay? So PDF, okay, run. Okay, so it is taking a bit time. Okay, so it has uploaded the file. Let us go and see whether it has really uploaded something. Oh, so here is the folder EISSMS, and you can check that PDF has been uploaded here. Now let us go and download this PDF again. Okay. So download a file. Now it is asking for the location. So the file is in EISSMS, and it is, the name of the file is, I think this, and it has extension PDF. Okay. So it is asking for the location where you want to store that file. So let us store that file in let us store it in desktop. Okay, so we need to get the path. Let us take the path. Okay, so this is the path. PDF. Okay, so it has downloaded that file, and we can see that file in. Oh, here it is. Okay, so yes, it has downloaded. Okay, now let us go and execute the final command, which is to check the files in the cloud. Okay, so there is a folder ek, there is a folder desktop. We don't have anything in those folders, and there is a folder ASMS, and we have one PDF file. Okay, so this is it. Thanks for watching, guys, and if you like this video, please click on the like button, do comment, and share this video, and do subscribe.